I'm Gina Provenzano. I'm so happy to be here, so grateful that you are here, so very grateful for these musicians. This has not been the easiest couple of 2 years. We would practice, we'd say, practice at home, we'll get together, and then canceled, as you know, for 2 years. And it's not easy to play in masks. It's not easy to play so spread out. It's just not easy to come back after 2 years. We've had limited rehearsal. We've had to do short little sectionals or little groups. But we are here, and we are happy to be here, and I'm glad you're here with us. So thank you. If I could have our board members stand up. I know we have one in the audience as well. If you could stand up, board members. These people, they had some really tough decisions the last couple years. And I'm very grateful to them, and I just wanted to acknowledge them because it was not easy to make some of the decisions we had to do. Our concert theme today is going to be a wee bit of spring. I thought it would be very clever since it's St. Patrick's Day was last week and today is the first day of spring. We couldn't have a nicer day. So I thought I'd put some music together that is Irish and spring related. So of course our first piece was Thunder and Lightning Polka by Strauss. That's why you heard the timpani and the bass drum playing. They were the thunder. Our next piece will be the Irish tune from County Derry, which is one of my favorites by Granger. We'll be playing the fourth movement of the Spring Symphony by Schumann, and then Salute to the Cinema, which is Somewhere Over the Rainbow, and Singing in the Rain are in that is in the piece, so I thought that would be fun. And then we're going to finish the concert with Irish Suite by Leroy Anderson. So it's going to be a great concert. Thank you for being here.
Thank you.
So I wanted to thank MCTV. They're here today videoing us, recording us. We are so happy for them. If you haven't checked out their website, you should do that. They offer a lot to our community, and we should be very grateful for them. So check it out. We also have on their YouTube channel, MCTV Network. You can look under their playlist, and you have all of our concerts there. So if you would like to watch some of our old concerts, they are there. But check their site out. There's a lot that they do for us in our community. I had an idea that I wanted to reach out to our nursing homes and assisted living facilities here in Midland, and I thought it would be nice to have what I was calling a watch party so that we would live stream our concert out to them. And MCTV was so grateful. They were so nice to help me out on that. And I'm happy to report that we have 10 nursing home and assisted living facilities right now watching our concert. So hello to you. We're happy that they're having a watch party, hopefully having some refreshments. Sorry we don't have any for you here. But they are hopefully having some refreshments and having a good time. So I wanted to give a little shout out. We have the Primrose Retirement Community out there, the Bickford Senior Living Center, the Brookdale Senior Living Center, Cascades Senior Living Center, Brittany Manor, King's Daughter's Home, which I've been told that Bea Springer had a 100th birthday on March 8th, and also Marianne Feeney has 101 on March 22nd. So happy birthday to Bea and Marianne. Everyone, round of applause. I'm hoping you're having a nice day there and had a nice birthday and are going to have a nice birthday. It is also Sarah's birthday right here. It's her birthday today. We also have Riverside Place Listening, Washington Woods, Meddy Lodge, and Stratford Pines. So we're hoping to do this for every concert. So our next concert is May 22nd, so we hope you'll be able to watch us then as well. And I hope you're enjoying the concert so far. Next, we will be playing Salute to the Cinema, and I think you'll love this piece. Thank you. I have a few more thank yous. I wanted to thank Jason Tisdale and Bullet Creek Auditorium. They do a wonderful job for us, and with all the cancellations and rescheduling, we really appreciate what they do for us. So thank you to Bullet Creek Auditorium and Jason Tisdale. I also, of course, have to thank Midland Public Schools for letting us use the Midland High School. And actually, Delta College also helped us out. There was one day where they had to do an intense cleaning, so we had to vacate, and Delta College let us use their new Midland Center. So we appreciate that. We want to thank those of you that brought food for the food pantry. The Midland County Emergency Food Pantry Network is very appreciative, and they could any continued support would be great. We try to help them out, so if you we appreciate if you brought any food for them. I just want to make a reminder that Give Local is on May 2nd, and we do appreciate if you keep us in mind for that. And I want to thank our donors. We would not be able to do what we do. This would not happen without our donors, and we are so grateful to you. We are in, actually, this is our 30th season. It was supposed to be 2 years ago, but this is the start of our 30th season. So we are so happy that we are able to do this, and we could not do it without our donors. Bob Ralston and Larry Gunther and Dr. Vern Stenger were three friends that got together and created what they called the Midland Civic Orchestra, which turned into the Midland Community Orchestra, and that was 30 years ago. Their first concert was on February 9th of 1992. Bob Ralston was the conductor for 16 years. Tim Frank was the conductor for 2 years. Wendy Hohmeyer, who is now in our flute section, wave your hand or stand up, Wendy. There she is. She was the conductor for 6 years. We're glad to have her in the flute section. And now I've been here, believe it or not, for 7 years. I started in 2015. So we're happy that we can continue this, but we could not do this without these musicians. So what I'd like to do is I'd like to have anyone that's in the audience is included in this. If you have ever played in the orchestra, would you please stand, including everyone on stage, and stay standing. Now, stay standing. If you've played longer than 5 years, stay standing and the rest of you sit down. So more than 5 years. How about more than 10 years? 15 years? It gets better. Watch this. 20 years. And remember, this is every Monday night from 7:30 to 9:45. What am I on? 15, 20 years. 25 years. And 30 years. Anybody out there? Oh, Jan's out there too. Thank you for doing that with us. I can't even imagine. That's such a wonderful thing. I think we have Jan out there was a charter member, and I think Esther, is that you over there? Esther, welcome back. She was our principal's second violin, and we were unable to say goodbye to her because of COVID. We were supposed to acknowledge her, but thank you for what you've done for us all those years, Esther. So our next concert will be May 22nd, and finally we're going to finish up with a 5 movements of a 6-movement piece called The Irish Suite. You're going to love it. I will say this, you're not supposed to clap between movements, but it's so good, I'm going to allow you to do it. So feel free to clap, and when you do, clap really loud. Thank you.
Thank you.